Hi everyone, welcome back. Jana here with a new process video for HipKitClub. I'm working with the January kits and my assignment for today is use a cut file. So I grabbed the cut file, it's 2020 from the HipKitClub store, and my original idea was to use the cut file as it is, so the outlines from the stars and from the title. But then I had a look at all the pretty stars and I decided to go with the full stars and not the outlines. And I'm also using, I also used the rainbow pattern paper from Pinkfresh Studio. And I went with the colors. So I'm totally in love with the arrangement from the colors. And there are tons of color coordinating stuff, and so I will do that. And you can see I placed my title, the It's 2020, on a pattern paper, and I fussy cut that out and I left a little border from the paper, and I also did a black outline on top of the letters and numbers. The picture shows me and my hobby at New Year's Eve, and we are taking selfies each year, and so I totally love to look back and how we change, and yeah, you know, I just love it. I'm just looking through the bits and pieces, and most of them is Pinkfresh Studio, and I'm grabbing some stuff that is matching the colors, some chipboard circles, some puffy words, and just looking, and I love it. So I decided to place my picture also on a pattern, on a black and white striped paper, and I'm just ruffling up the edges, and most of the stars are already glued down, so I took a little break and I just glued the stars down. It's much easier to work on a layout when the base from the design is already on the paper, so you don't need to worry about losing some stars or, you know, yeah. So popping up the picture with some foam tape, and then I will also add some 3D squares onto my title so that I will have some more dimension and shadow. And next to that, I have not used any mixed media here, and it felt a bit strange because I'm doing that all the time, but also very relaxing not to use any mixed media. And I also decided to work on a craft paper, and I totally love how the colors are looking on top of it. And so no mixed media today, but I still love it, and I hope you will like it too. So now I'm gluing down the chipboard stickers and the puffy words, but I will go back and add some dimension tape to the chipboard circles just for some more dimension and interest. And I totally love how this is coming together. And you can see I already added some tiny stars in white. And in I punched them out from a packaging, so it's a grayish, it's a white paper with gray lines on it. And I totally love how the white stars are looking, and I totally love the colors here, and I'm just totally happy how the page turned out. And here you can see everything is glued down, the circles got some dimension tape. I'm sorry, and now I'm going back to add some pops of black. I added the little chipboard heart that said this, and here I'm bringing in some puffy hearts, and I'm placing color on color, so there is each chipboard circle will get a little puffy heart, and I totally love that little detail. These are some white puffy stickers, letters, and I'm just adding two words, love and fun. And then I will also bring in some XOs from the Great Paper stickers. But next to that, I am done, and I am totally in love. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this process too. And you will get a close-up in a second and some final pictures at the end. And yeah, that's it for now. Thanks for stopping by and talk to you soon. Bye.